स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छसुच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रयन्ताम्बूमधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्ति छिदो नखाः. इन् द टापिक् आफ् संवाद वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् त्री टैप्स् आफ् संवाद. आनन्दवर्धना सेट् दट् देर् आर् त्री टैप्स्. तत्र पूर्वम् अनन्यात्म तुच्छात्म तदनन्तरं तृतीयं तु प्रसिद्धात्म नान्यसाम्यं त्यजेत् कविः न अन्यसाम्यं त्यजेत् कविः. सो अन्यसाम्यम् ईवन् इफ् संथिङ्ग् follows the lines of an ancient poet, it still need not be left off by a poet. He can adopt it, he can use it in his style and try to portray a different type of meaning with it. So tritiyam samvadam na tyajet. So kavihi, a poet should not let go of this tritiya samvada. Just because there are coincidences, he need not do that. But at the end also, Anandavardhana says, even if a poet does not want to follow the ancient works, ancient people's writings, he does not want to take an idea from them, Saraswati will somehow find a way to come into his pratibha and give him a way of expression. So it is not necessary that this is the only way to go. It's not that you only have to look at ancient ideas, ancient poetry, and write in that chaya. Not necessary. That also he gives at the end. But while saying while enlisting the three types of samvada, he says the third type should not be in na tyajyaha. Etadeva upabhadayutum uchyate आत्मनो अन्यस्य सद्भावे पूर्वस्थित्यनुयायपि वस्तु भातितरां तन्व्याः शशिच्छायम् इव आननम्. आत्मनः अन्यस्य सद्भावे, अन्यस्य तत्त्वस्य सद्भावे. सो अन्यस्य तत्त्वस्य सद्भावे इत्युक्ते ईवन् वेन् देर् इस् ए विलक्षण रसादि सद्भावे सद्भावे पूर्वस्थिति अनुयायि अपि, ईवन् दो इट् टेक्स् द फार्म् अण्ड् ब्यूटि आफ् संथिङ्ग् दट् हेस् आलरेडि बीन् सेड् बिफोर्, येट् देर् इस् इट् डिस्टिङ्ग्विशेस् इट् सेल्फ् फ्रम् एन्शियण्ट् वर्क्स्. अन्यस्य सद्भावे देर् इस् अ विलक्षणत्वं प्रेसेण्ट् इन् द प्रेसेण्ट् पोयट्स् कवि, ईवन् इफ् इट् इस् देर् देन् इट् इस् वस्तु भातितराम्, इट् डस् shine beautifully. There is no punaruktattvam there. Just like shashi chayam iva tanvyaha ananam. Just like when you say the lady's face is like the moon, moon's beauty, there is no punaruktattvam there. It is not that both are the same. There is a repetition of ideas. It doesn't matter. Even if you say the same thing that a girl's face is like a moon. So tattvasya, explaining that karika, he says tattvasya सारभूतस्य आत्मनः सद्भावे अन्यस्य. सो आत्मनः तत्त्वस्य अन्यस्य तत्त्वस्य सारभूतस्य सद्भावे. वेन् देर् इस् दि आत्मा आर् वेन् द सोल् आफ् दट् पोयट्री हेज् समथिङ्ग् वेरि डिफरेण्ट् फ्रम् वाट् पीपल् हेव् सेड् बिफोर्, येट् इट् ईस् फालोयिङ्ग् वाट् पीपल् हेव् सेड् बिफोर्. पूर्वस्थिति अनुयायी अपि वस्तु भातितराम् पुराण रमणीय छाया अनुग्रहीतम् अनुग्रहीतम् छाया अनुयायि, इट् इस् फालोयिङ्ग् द पूर्वच्छाया अनुग्रहीतम् हि वस्तु शरीरवत् परां शोभां पुष्यति. सन् लुक्स् लैक् द फादर्, हि हेज् अ ब्यूटि or that handsomeness that the father also has, the son also has, but there is a shade of it. He may be different in his own way, right? But the shariravat, just like how they share similarities, yet there is a greater beauty to both. Each one shines in a different manner. Nadu punaruktatvena avabhasate, there is no repetition. Tanyaha shashichayam eva anana. Evam tavat, sasambadanam samudayarupanam vakyarthanam vibaktaha simaha. So the lines have been drawn between samvada, yukta, different types of similar sentence meaning. Samudaya rupana, in that entire set of vakyartha that we find sentence meanings, which are coincidental, samvadam, sa samvada, samvada yuktanam vakyanam, simanaha, the borders of them are vibhaktaha, it is separate. Padartha rupanam cha vastvantara sadrishanam kavya vastunam nastyeva doshaha. इति प्रतिपादयितुम् उच्यते. सो देर् इस् नो फाल्ट् इफ् इट् फालोस् एन् अदर् वस्तु. So vastu antara, vastu can be shabda, pada, padartha and plot. Padartha rupanam vastu antara sadrisham, when it is very close in meaning to another vastu. Kavya vastu nam, those poetry also nasti eva dosha, there is no fault in those poetry. How? Aksharadi rachana iva yojyate yatra vastu rachana puratani nutane spurati kavya vastuni vyaktameva khalusa nadushyati. Aksharadi rachana iva yatra yasmin nutana kavya vastuni spurati sati. When there is a new poetry that has come about, spurati sati, when it flashes, or when a new material appears, Aksharadi rachana iva puratani vastu rachana yojyate, and when in that new kavyam, aksharadi rachana iva. See, that's why he says in the Karika, vachaspatina api aksharani padani va kanichat apurvani ghatayitum na shakyante. Even vachaspati cannot bring about newer syllables. Right? If it is a different language, then you can have different syllables. But you have only akaranta, akaradi, kshakaranta, atmika. So there are only 51 varnam. And even vachaspati, even brihaspati cannot create a new varnam. So aksharadi rachana iva, just like how we have to use the existing syllables, in the same manner, arrangement of old meaning is also okay. So vastu rachana api puratani vastu rachana api yojyate, you use that puratanam, old arrangement of meaning can also be used, and when that is used, sana dushyati khalu nahi vachaspatina api aksharani padani va kanichit apurvani ghatayitum shakyante. He cannot create new syllables or new words. See, creating new words are, when we say vahana chalakaha for driver, it is, we are only using words that already exist. We are only using it in a different rachana. That's all. Vahanam asti, chalakaha asti. So we are only using it in a different context today. Right? Tani tu, tanyeva upanibadhani, na kavyadishu navatam viruddhyanti. Tani tu tanyeva upanibaddhani. Tanyeva upanibaddhani means tani tu apurvani. Tanyeva upanibaddhani, when they are being used as those which have been said in the previous sentence, when they are being used in a kavya. So that is the difference between the two tani. So tani purva uktani etani padani yeti upanibadhyamanani kavyadishu navatam na viruddhyanti. It does not contradict newness. So it does not hinder any originality. There is an originality there. Tathaiva padartha rupani sleshadimayani arthatattvani api. When we use letters and words that have already been used, yaneva shabdan vayamalapamaha taneva vishesha vinyasa bhavaihi. So we use the same words, yet it is original. That is why there are so many simple shlokas, yet the idea, the way the poet has conveyed it is so beautiful that it seems as if it is completely new, that the poet has coined it somehow. But the words are very similar, very familiar to us, right? So navatam na viruddhyati, it does not hinder any originality. There is originality in it. Tathaiva, in the same manner, we can look at meaning also. Yaneva arthancha ullikama. So even those artham that we wish to highlight, using slasha, etc., it can give a new shade to the poetry. Tasmat sankshepena yadapi tadapi ramyam yatra lokasya kinchit spuritam idim itiyam buddhir abhyujjihite anugatam api purvat chayaya vastu tadrik sukavir upanibadhanan nindyatam nopayati. He concludes by saying, yadapi tadapi ramyam, yatra lokasya kinchit. Lokasya yadapi tadapi ramyam kinchit asti spuritam idam iti iyam buddhihi abhyujjihite. When a poet, anything that is beautiful in the world, yadapi tadapi ramyam lokasya kinchit asti, किञ्चित् स्फुरितम् इफ् इफ् इट् इफ् इट् फ्लाशस् इन् हिस् मैण्ड् एण्ड् ही रियलैसेस् देट् एण्ड् इट् इट् टेक्स् आन् अ स्पेशल् मीनिङ्ग् इन् द पोयट्स् मैण्ड् दट् स्फुरणं स्फुरणा इयं काचित् इति सहृदयानां चमत्कृतिः उत्पद्यते. So chamatkara is a word that Abhinav Gupta uses a lot in his vyakhyanam, but I don't think we came across Anandavardhana using this word chamakriti or chamatkara, not sure. So spurana iyam kachit, when he says spuritam idam, that ramyam, when it gains an originality, chamatkriti, abhyujjihate, what happens? Anugatam api purvachhayaya, even if it follows purvachhaya, even if it is purvachhaya anugrihitam api, tadrik vastu sukavihi nibadhnan, upanibadhnan, when a good poet uses it in his poetry, nindyatam na upayati, he does not incur any ninda, he does not undergo any ninda from critics. They will in fact praise him only. There was a paper, I read a paper where someone had compared both Kalidasa and Bhavabhuti. So many places where from either Meghasandesham or Abhijnana Shakuntalam, it is completely reflected in Bhavabhuti's Malati Madhavam and Uttaramacharitam. Very few in Mahavira Charitam, of course, but the same idea, but it has been expressed in a different manner by Bhavabhuti. So we appreciate both equally. There is nobody who can deny the greatness of Bhavabhuti today. Nor do we say, you know, he has copied from Kalidasa. We don't say it is copied. Great men think alike. There is a unique beauty to how Bhavabhuti expresses it. Tad anugatamabhi purvachhayaya vastu tadrik tadriksham सुकविहि विवक्षित व्यंग्य वाच्यार्थ समर्पण समर्थ शब्द रचना रूपया बंधच्छायया उपनिबद्धनन् निन्द्यतां नैव याति. सो हाउ डज ही यूज द अर्लियर पोएट्री? ही यूजेस इट इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ शब्दरचना रूपया, इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ कंपोजिशन विच इज समर्थ, विच इज केपेबल ऑफ giving us the both the vachyartham and the vengyartham, that is vivakshitam, that the poet wishes to convey or the sahridaya wishes to enjoy. It is beautifully revealed, and he uses such a composition to create a kavyam, even if it follows a purana bandhachaya, tathapi naiva nindyatam yati. He is not censured by others. He is not abused by others. He is a copycat. Nobody says that. Taditham sthitam pratayantam vacho nimita vividhartha amrita rasa na sadak kartavyah kavibhir anavadye svavishaye. Now, in a flip side, even if he doesn't have to worry, you know, a poet wants to express his originality, he may not feel like taking the same idea. So many people have written about Ramayanam and Mahabharatam and all that. A poet might just come about, why don't I just say, you know, Nrisimha Charitam or something like that, I can write something new, right? Or a personality that I have met today, or Tyagaraja, no? Or Dikshita, someone can just write about a personality that they have met in their life also. And that can be an inspiration or even an idea. Not necessary that you have to describe pushpam to only Shankashukti or there are humorous ways of expressing of how, you know, that adla varume anda adena vrichakatikathla nanikira, where the vidushaka tries to say how it is like a buffalo skirt, apdinla he will make a comparison. So I forget that. So that is where the hasyatvam comes in, you know. So it's the poet's creativity to how to describe or connect the descriptions to existing upama or something new. You can say cotton ball, you can compare it to a cotton ball. The moon can be compared to tire, dosa. You know, you say it is like a dosa that someone did on the sky. That is how a child will look at it. So everything can contribute to a newness to it, right? So pratayantam vachaha nimita vividha artha amrita rasaha na sadhak kartavyaha. See, a poet should not worry if he wants to create something which is totally new and which does not follow another person's ichcha. So paraswadana ichcha virata manasaha. He does not, he's turned away his mind from paraswada, from another person's beautiful expressions. Wait, I'm moving away from the first part of the this thing. Pratayantam means tana vistarane. From tana vistarane, you have the nijantam, which is pratayantam. Let it flow out. Let the words flow, and the words are like nimita, vividha, artha, amrita, sara. It is like nectar, amrita, sara, with different types of artham, which is nimitam. Nimita means equal. Mitam is balanced. It is balanced as far as both vachyartha and vyangyartha is concerned, or it has a balance of rasa, guna, everything. Everything is put in that appropriate levels that it has to be in a kavyam. So nimita, nimita ityukte, well, equal, sama, vividha artha amrita rasaha vachaha pratayantam. Let the words flow with such a balance. Poet should not worry about. So when you have an inspiration and a poet just writes, he should not worry about anavadye svavishaye sadaha na kartavyaha. Even if it doesn't follow the earlier poet's version, if his particular work is without any fault, svavishaye anavadye kavibihi sadaha na kartavyaha vishadaha na kartavyaha dukkham na kartavyam. They should not worry too much about, see, you know, even if my poetry is without any fault, yet, oh my God, I should have taken that idea from another poet. You don't need to worry about all of these things. So santi navaha kavyartha para upanibaddartha virachane na kaschit kavehe gunaha iti bhavayitva. So para upanibaddartha virachane navaha kavyartha. No. Okay. So there should be a comma after. Sorry, where is that? Pratayantam. There should be a comma here. Santi navaha kavyartha. Naveshu kavyartheshu satsu api. पर उपनिबद्धार्थ विरचने कवेः कश्चित् गुणः न विद्यते इति यदि कविः भावयति. दैट्स हाउ यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट सेंटेंस. सो इन केस ए पर्सन थिंक्स देयर आर सो मेनी न्यू पोएट्रीज नवाः काव्यार्थाः सन्ति एव तर्हि पूर्वेषां काव्यार्थ छायाम् अनुसृत्य किमर्थं कर्तव्यं. वाई शुड आई नाउ यू नो मेक एन एफर्ट टू टेक द एंशियंट पोएट्री एंड ट्राई टू build up on that. I can do a new thing, right? But someone might say, na kaschit gunaha, there is no beauty in it. If a poet feels personally, if he feels there are a lot of new poetries and people are writing newer themes, when Nilakantha Dikshita came about with Nilakantha Vijaya Champu, nobody had written a champu on Paramashiva. There had been Ramayanam, there had been Bharata Champu, there had been Nala Champu. Nobody thought of taking up Shiva's story and doing it as a champu. And his thought, his Kavya Vastu was new there. So when there are such newer themes that are being taken, if I think of taking up Ramayanam again and writing a poetry, there is no point in it. So I have to come up with some newer idea, right? If I write a champu on Narasimha, then it is something new which nobody has thought about, right? So kaschit gunaha iti, that could be my personal attitude. If such a poet has such a personal attitude, kavehe yadi na kaschit gunaha iti kavihi yadi bhavayati tarhi paraswadana iccha virata manasaha sukavehe vastu saraswati esha yatheshtam ghatayati bhagavati. She automatically comes and gives that creativity to that poet. She won't let go of such a person. You know, if he has that creativity, automatically that vastu will come in his, will flash in his brain. You can't help it. So paraswadana, paraswadana, yeah. Adanam dane, eduthukiradhu. Or para swa adana. Parasya swasya eva adanam. I don't know how he has split here. We will just take it like that. Taking another person's, to take an idea from another person, this sukavi, his mind, whose mind manasaha is virata, is averse to taking the idea from another person. When he is averse to taking the property of another person, paraswam. Tasya adana. Ah, okay. Parasya swam. Swam ityukte property. So taking the property of somebody else's, this poet is totally averse to it. For him, Sukavehe, Saraswati Esha Bhagavati, this goddess Saraswati, Yatheshtam Vastu Ghatayati. She will automatically connect, or she will give what he seeks. So Yesham Sukavinam Pratana Punya Abhyasa Paripaka Vashena Pravrittihi. For those poets who have a pravritti, who have a desire to write poetry because of Pratana Janmavidya, Pratana Punya Pakam, and because of Punyam that has been earned in previous Janma, Abhyasa by constant practice. And then paripaka vashena, because of that thoughts in him are ripened, or it is at that particular fruition point. Any karma that we have done, we will not be experiencing the papa phalan or the punya phalan immediately at that point. So we don't know which punya karma, which papa karma is at the point of paripaka. Is at the point of fruition. Only then will it start giving the phalan. So here, paraktana punya abhyasanamcha paripaka vashena, because it is at the right time to produce a result in this point, in that poet, stasya pravrittihi bhavati, kavye pravrittihi bhavati. Tesham kavinam paroparachita paroparachitartha parauparachitartha parigraha nispruhanam. They are detached from taking the meaning from another person. Svavyaparaha na kaschit upayujyate parasya, or tesham vyaparaha na upayujyate. They do not take the other people's vyaparam or other people's idea. Bhagavati Saraswati saeva Bhagavati Saraswati swayam abhimatam artham avirbhavayati. She ensures that they are able to get that spark of originality, and she gives them that idea, whatever that kavi wants. Etadeva hi mahakavitvam mahakavinam iti om. I rest my case here. That's what he says. Iti om. So mahakavina mahakavitvam. The greatness of a mahakavi lies in that. If he does not, even if he does not wish to get the, take the idea from another person, Saraswati will automatically give what he wants because of the praktana punya vashat, abhyasa vashat, punyanam abhyasanam cha atra aduna paripaka vashat tesham kavye pravrittihi bhavedeva nischayam. Okay. Iti aklishta rasashrayochita gunalankara shobha bhritaha yasmat vastu samihitam sukritibihi sarvam samasadyate kavyakhye akhila saukhya dhamni vibhudodhyane dhvanir darshitaha soyam kalpatarupamana mahima bhogyo astu bhavyatmanam. So Anandavardhana finishes his fourth udyota with this. Iti, thus I have you know, kavyakhye akhila saukhya dhamni vibhudha udyane dhvanihi darshitaha maya. I have shown dhvani in this great garden of poetry. This garden is like a sura udyanam, vibhudha udyanam. It is the garden of gods. Devanam udyanam kavyakhyam अखिल सौख्य धामनी, इट इज लाइक हाउस ऑफ धाम, हाउस रेजिडेंस ऑफ सौख्यम, इट इज रेजिडेंस ऑफ ऑल हैप्पीनेस ऑल डिलाइट्स, सच इन दिस काव्यम आई हैव शोन वेयर ध्वनि इज ना. सुकृतिभिः यस्मात् काव्यात् वस्तु समीहितं सर्वं समासाद्यते, फ्रॉम दिस काव्यम पीपल कैन गेट व्हाट एवर दे वांट. सुकृतिभिः poets can get whatever they want, sarvam samasadyate, everything is attained by a good poet, he gets whatever he wishes from this poetry. Yasmat katham asti kavyam aklishta rasa ashraya uchita guna alankara shobha bhritaha, this poet, this poetry which has bharati, so it has bhrit means it has shobha, it has a beauty because of guna and alankara which are uchitam, which are put in a very appropriate manner to give rise to aklishta rasa ashrayam. Aklishtam adosham, there is no dosha, without any rasa doshas attached to it, the rasa rasaha eva ashrayaha, that is every guna and alankara that is being used by a poet should be rasa ashritam. This is what we have read everything. So upasamharam means you have to sort of combine whatever he has said before, right, in all four udyotas. So everywhere he has tried to point out dhvani in a kavyam which has beauty shobha bhritaha and alankaras which have been used appropriately to highlight rasa, rasa ashraya uchita alankara and rasa ashraya uchita gunam, it's like a conclusion for the entire four udyotas. So yasmat vastu samihitam sukritibhi samihitam vastu sarvam samasadyate, when poets can get from this garden of poetry anything that they wish, samihitam asmin kavyakhe vibhuda udyane akila saukhya damni vibhuda udyane kavyakhe dvanihi maya darshitah, so yam dvanihi, that dvani kalpataru upamana mahima, it has a greatness of being compared to a kalpataru, it can have the only upama that I upamanam that I give can give the standard of comparison for dvani is kalpataru. Whatever you want you can get from it, you want something based on shabdam, yes, yet there should be dvani, so shabda vyanjana also can be there, arthi vyanjana can be there, you can use gunibhuta vyangam also along with dvani. I have given you some innumerable varieties, if you look at Kavya Prakasham there is some 5000 varieties he gives, so it is like kalpataru, right, we in our lifetime we wouldn't have accumulated 5000 of anything, but dvani is so much of variety I have shown you today, correct, it is like kalpataru upamana mahima, its greatness is like kalpataru because it can give whatever the poet wishes for. Bhavyatmanam bhogyah astu, let sahrudayas enjoy it, bhogya vastu, let it be a bhogya vastu, something that can be enjoyed by sahrudaya. Next is like what is the abideya vastu and what he has, the poet himself, he talks about what is the poetry that he has said. So satkavya tatva naya vartma chira prasuptam, I have not said anything that is new. As a conclusion, usually upakrama upasamhara should be the same in a work. So as he had started kavyasyatma dvaniriti budhaihi yas samamnata purvaha, he ends with the same note saying chira prasupta kalpam manasu paripakva dhyam yat asit tadeva vyakarot anandavardhanah, whatever was till now sleeping in the minds of the paripakva dhyam, only sahrudayas could understand that dhvani which was sleeping for a long time in their minds, I have shown it today for the enjoyment of sahrudaya. So satkavya tatva nayavartma chira prasupta kalpam manasu paripakva dhyam yadasit tad vyakarot sahrudaya udaya labha hetoho anandavardhanah iti prathita abhidanah. So anandavardhanah iti prathita abhidanah, this famous anandavardhana has now vyakarot, I have now explained it this has been explained by this Ananda Vardhana. For what? Sahridaya Udaya Labha Hetoho. Udayam is happiness. For the happiness of Sahridaya, for the benefit of Sahridaya also, I have explained this, which has been in the minds of Paripakva Dhyam Manasu, which has been in the minds of people, sleeping in the minds of people. Yadu Chiras Chira Prasupta Kalpam, as if it were sleeping. Kalpapa is a pratyayam we've seen in Luptopama, right? Chira Prasupta Kalpam, it is as if it has been sleeping for a long time. What is that? Satkavya Tattva Nayavartma. So Satkavyam, what is a good poetry? Tasya Tattvam Sarabhutam Kim Asti Dhvani. Tasya Nayaha, the politics, the analysis of it. And Vartma, the margam that gives us to write a good poetry or to highlight that dhvani in that poetry. Each one is four things. So what is a satkavyam? What is its tattvam? What is the process by which we understand it? And how do we implement it? Vartma. So satkavya tattva, tattva naya vartma, which people knew about it before. It was not explained like this. In Vyakaroti, Vyakaroti means, even Vyakaranam is Vivichya Jnayate iti Vyakaranam. So Vyakarot ityukte Vivichya Akarot. I have just given you the classifications and clearly laid it out in front of you for the experience and benefit of Sahridaya. Yeah, with this in hand, it's like a tool for us to understand good poetry or weigh the pros and cons and try to find out which is better. Right?